Hello, welcome students. Good afternoon.
Here Saru sir.
With a new video of class 6 English. Students, we have already covered chapter 6 chapter of English. This is chapter 7. And the name of this poem, there is poem named The Brook. Students, in earlier video, we have discussed three stanzas of this poem, The Brook, written by Alfred Lord Tennyson. Alfred Lord Tennyson is a nature poet, and if we see in three stanzas, the adventurous way of brook, that small river, is mentioned where it goes and pass through. And if we see figure of speech used in this poem is personification, because the river is telling its story itself, and poet Alfred Lord Tennyson makes the brook as a person, as by the word of its everything is in terms. So what we say, we have completed three stanzas in earlier video. In this video we are going to forward further stanzas. Students, if we see the third stanza we have completed, and fourth stanza is, I chatter over stony ways in little sharps and trebles. I bubble into adding bass. I babble on the pebbles. Students, page number 52 should be open on your in your course book, and you see we have completed three stanzas. Fourth stanza is, I chatter over stony ways. Who is I in this poem? The brook, the small river. So what it says? It says that I chatter over stony ways. If we see what is chatter, chatter means to talk. Chatter means to talk. That means in little sharps and trebles. So the voice of river, the brook, whenever it passing through, so it is talking about its own voice. How it says, it says, I chatter over stony ways. Whenever it passes from the stony ways, the ways of stones, in the rocky ways, you can say the stony ways, you know, in ways, in the path where rocks and stones are founded. So in that ways, by kicking them, there is a voice, there is a treble. What is voice? There is a trebles, and that trebles means, if you see in word body, a high pitched voice. Students, I chatter over stony ways in little sharps and trebles. Students, here sharp and trebles is equal, having equal meaning. If you see, I chatter over stony ways in little sharps and trebles. So it travelled on stony ways, or passed, or chatter over stony ways. That means the voice, when it was passing from or upon the stony ways, the voice which was coming there, it was personification, as the brook says, it's chattering. Okay. And in little sharps and trebles, sharps and trebles is a phrasal, is a phrase, you can say, sharps and trebles. So meaning of both is same, like neat and clean. So the meaning of neat and clean both is same, like that. Sharps and trebles here, same. That means the voice was of high pitched, somehow it was, you know, high pitched voice and high voice, you know, it was sound some kind of, and it was some kind of the clurging of water, and you can say the flowing of water, sound of the flowing of water is there. And the brook says itself, it's chattering, and it says, I chatter over the stony ways in little sharps and trebles. So somewhere, somehow, it travels, when it travels or it goes through the stony ways, it shouts in little voice, little it shouts in high pitched voice. So some time it shouted, or some time it, you can say, chattered over stony ways in soft voice and high pitched voice. Trebles means in high pitched voice. Then what happens? I bubble into adding bass. Students, if you see the meaning of bass, bass means sea. You know, Bay of Bengal, if you see. So, a small sea there, you know, pit seas, you know. So, I chatter over stony ways in little sharps and trebles. I bubble into adding bass. I bubble on the pebbles. So, students, I bubble into adding bass. That means, whenever the river goes through as a sea, when it becomes as a sea or a bay, so when, what is adding, students? Circular movement of water. Sometimes if you see in river, if there is any curve and, you know, turn ways and paths, so sometimes the circular movement of water becomes there or starts there. Have you seen this circular movement of water in the start, in the middle of river or side of river? And that I bubble into adding base. So if there is circular movement of water in between of rivers, so river says that I bubble into adding base. So the voice, when that circular movement of water starts, that voice is the bubble of, you know, the river brook. So it says, I bubble into adding base, I bubble on the pebbles. So whenever it passes through a stony ways, the path where is, there are stones and rocks, its little sharps and treble, it sounded in high pitched voice, and I bubble into adding base, and in circular movement also river used to get some voice, that it is telling that its bubbles, you know, its voice that of drops of water in circular movement of water. And here the word is used, adding base, that means circular movement of water. In that circular movement of water, the drops of water were laying there, the voice of there is. So it says that I bubble into adding base, I bubble on the pebbles. So students, here pebbles is used for drops of water. So I bubble on the pebbles. So in every drops of water, there is sound and there is a voice of the brook. It's its soul, is in there, and in every drops and every circular movement of water, you say, every chatter over stony ways, whenever it passes through the stones, there is a voice, there is a sound, there is a chattering, there is a music, and it is expression of the brook river itself, that the music and the sound which is coming from the circular movement of water, and you can say by chatter or by passing over the stony ways and the stone path. So that all music and that all sounds was, you know, adventurous for the brook, the river. And if you see in second stanza, with many a curve my banks I fret. What is the meaning of fret? Fret means be disturbed or be in problem. So with many a curve my banks I fret. So the brook says there are many curves on the banks of it, and the curve is a kind of fret for it, a kind of problem or tension, a kind of concern that is about of worry. So it is a fret to that there was curves, and by many a field and follow, and in that curves nearby them, the banks of river, nearby the banks of river, we see many a field and follow. So field and follow also so if you see Like here, sharps and trebles. If you see what is trebles, trebles is high pitched voice. And if you see sharp, sharp means voice in sharp way. So somehow we see they are antonyms of each other. Like that word here, fill and follow. So two words are used here, sharps and trebles. And if you see, fill and follow. So these both words are antonyms of each other. That means in little sharps and trebles it says that somewhere is sharps means in low pitched voice, but would be go to further and further. And trebles, that is high pitched voice. So some time river pitched low or sharp we can say, and sometime on high pitch. And that similar words or phrase has been used in, if you see fourth stanza, fifth stanza, second line, by a many field and follow. So the river passes through, there are banks of rivers, curves which are, turn ways of rivers, if you see, turn ways of rivers. So these are curves, and in between of them and between of them we see many field and follow. Field, it is matter of cultivated field. That field which is in cultivation, using in cultivation. And follow, that means if you see, plucked and left farmland without being sown, until land. That you see the meaning. The until land, that means which is not cultivated. So, in the paths of the brook, the small river, we see curves, banks are there like that. And nearby that banks, there were some field which is in cultivation, in thoroughly cultivation, and some fields are there which has been not cultivated since some time. So both type of lands, uncultivated and cultivated lands, both type of lands were there nearby banks of river, and many a fairy foreland set with willow, weed and. So students, here poet expresses the happiness of his adventurous way, its adventurous way. And if you see the word, and many a fairy foreland set. So what is the meaning of foreland? An area of land bordering another land. If you see the meaning of foreland, an area of land bordering another land. So that means the curves of rivers. And there are some areas which are different from the bank of rivers. So that areas are, here used many forelands. That means fairy foreland, that areas which are, situated in true harmonious condition. If we see flowers, fruits, trees, plants, greeneries, sceneries, and so many are, good looking and good for our eyes, things like that are in nearby areas of the bank of rivers. And fairy foreland set, that means so many lands were there where we can say fairy had been or has been used to come. That means it is an imagination of the river, that area where the regions, beautiful regions where flowers, fruits, trees and forests are covered, and some areas which we have imagined in our dream, and we see in some sceneries and photos. So that kind of areas were there also, and poet named them as a foreland set, as a fairy foreland set. That means areas with flowers, musical areas, and there is voice of rivers, and at the same time there is beautiful area of flowers and fruits and all. So poet imagined that there were fairy used to come, and the area is fairy foreland. That means good hygienic area and very adventurous, at the same time natural sceneries are there. So students, and many a fairy foreland set with willow, weed and mallow. If you see what is willow weed, that if you see in Hindi, willow kharpatwar, that means an European species of loose strife. So there is a loose strife willow named, in European countries this name loose strife is there, that means willow weed, which means, you know,
kharpatwar.
And willow is the name of that weed. That is strife, a loose strife in an European species of loose strife. Okay? And if we see mallow, that means a wild plant, ek prakar ka jangli pauda, and wild plant. So these two plants' name and strife name has been used here. So it is telling about that foreland set. What was set of that foreland? Some willow weed, that means an European species of loose strife, willow named, okay, strife, and there was a wild plant named mallow. In that whole foreland nearby. So this was the, you know, this is all mentioned about the ways, adventurous ways of the small river, what by it passes and what comes in the way of it. And if we see sixth stanza, I chatter as I flow to join the brimming river, for man may come and may go, but I go on for it. So students, you have to understand, this man comes and go in his work or her work, but river is the name of going forever. There is a message that the small river meets in a big river, in the brimming of big river. What is brimming, students? Completely full to the top edge. So all small rivers wants to go to meet in brimming of rivers and brimming of river and want to expand itself further. So this is the lust and this is the, you know, wish of all rivers, all small rivers, to meet in big rivers and become brimming part of that river. So for what is the aim of that small rivers? That there is a message that as a brook, as a small river, it has to go further and further, has to be forwarded, has to be moved on. And it says that for man may come and may go, but I go on forever. So any human beings can be, you know, travel back and further and forward, but river has to be always travel forwardly. So this is a message and strong message, and this is some kind of personification, that a person has to be moving, move on forward. It there is no should be any thought of, you know, looseness or, you know, loss and failure. So these all things are in message in the mind of Lord Alfred Tennyson. If we see the last chapter, if we see today's video's last chapter, a stanza, if we see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, this is 7th stanza. I wind about and in and out, with here a blossom selling, and here their lusty trot, and here and there grading. So students, the book says about itself that it wind about and in and out. So the river's water wind in and out by the help of your air and the curved way and the nearby region. So it's come in and out, it's go in and it comes out, with here a blossom sailing. So the speed and sailing and the, you know, way that rivers flows through. So it was a blossom sailing, that means it was tremendous and beautiful and you know, seeable sailing, and here and there lusty fruit, and nearby the banks there were some strong, you know, truth, there is a kind of fish. You have to understand, students, T-R-O-U-T. So that means a kind of fish. Kind of fish. So students, what is the meaning of lusty? If you see the meaning, that means strong, healthy. So a strong and healthy fish called trout, T-R-O-U-T, was there. And here and there a grayling. So there was a, you know, the sea and heavy trout, and in the blossom selling of that river, the brook, that fish was going to here and there, and like that the water also was coming in and out in its blossom selling. And what it says that the brook, the happy brook, is in its way, and in its way lot of natural sceneries and beauties was there, natural animals like some beautiful healthy fishes and stripes, some billowing and wallowing. We see some fruits and flowers and some sceneries were there, and all the adventurous path and way which the brook and this river has mentioned by Alfred Lord Tennyson is tremendous to understand. And if you see the words used as personification, we see in this poem which figure of speech is being used. So we can say personification, that means if we make any non-living things as a person and explain like that, so that time the figure of speech personification has been used. So students, today we completed up to 7 stanzas of this poem. In next video we will read further. In homework you have to write all word body of this poem and summary and explanation and analysis up to which I have been taught to you in today's video. Students, and read more and more for better results. Till then, have a nice day. Thank you.